The applause is back. The instrumentals is back. I'm back. If you don't know where you at, welcome back. God Talk Live. I'm your host, Sean of God Radio. Shine August. The Haitian sensation. The R&B sensation. Real nigga blues in your picket. Right now. R&B 2 coming soon. Coming on your face. Real soon. Work Wednesday, man. I will be in the fucking studio. I got to work out after God Talk, of course. But today is motherfucking Work Wednesday. To all my workers out there, 5 to 9, we praise God. 9 to 5, we do our 9 to 5. And then 5 to 9, we moonlight / hustle / Work Wednesday. You got time to do everything and please everybody. Make sure you break down your days in that mathematical godly order. If you in this thing, make sure you comment. I can't see who's in here unless you comment. So please send a comment if you're watching now, if you're watching later on YouTube, if you're listening on Apple Podcasts, iTunes, Spotify. Please tap in. I appreciate everybody for listening to last week's show. We had a great show. I didn't get to any of my fucking notes because Lil Nas X threw the whole world off. And before that, we had Ship Talk LA, another great episode. All these episodes are uploaded. Feel free to tap in with all of them. But before we go too crazy, let's just go ahead and bow our heads. Let's just usher Big Pops in this thing. Father God, I just want to, of course, before I ask you for anything, I got to thank you for everything. What I want to thank you for right now are just the five senses that come standard, that come along with us experiencing the world, that come along with just the care package of being human, being your child. I want to thank you for every sense that we take for granted. If I'm going to ask you for anything, Father, I want to ask that you make us a multi-sensory being, Father. Let us see the world and all these experiences with more than just our human senses. Let us grow, let us observe, let us learn, teach, and have a great, great time, especially on Work Wednesday, all throughout the week. In your name I pray, amen. Hey, listen, I got notes in this bitch. We about to be real professional. But what I do want to say real quick, when I started going on a journey, I was a dumb nigga, man. I was a bitch nigga. I was a liar. I was a cheat. I don't want you. Name that movie. You know that movie, Wavy? American Dream, Jackson 5. Remember when Catherine was limping and she called Joe on the phone? You was a lie. You was a cheat. But anyway, man, I wasn't the best person. I wasn't always the best version of myself. But I did start a journey. The first book that I did read was Decoded by Jay-Z. And in that book, Jay-Z was having a discussion with Oprah, and he was discussing Seat of the Soul by Gary Zukav, which was one of the most intriguing, most necessary books I've ever read. And it healed me. If you don't know, of course, I lost my mother. I lost pretty much all the women I'm blood related to in my family. And that book healed me. And I know, like every time I finish a book, every time I finish anything, I know when it's going to change my life. And oftentimes I let those people around me know, like, yo, I'm about to undergo a change, and just be aware. I want to tell you this so you don't think I'm acting funny. So when I read this book, I got halfway through the book and the book was doing so much great for my life. I bought it for all my friends, including my baby mother. Some read, some didn't. The ones that did are around right now. The ones that didn't aren't around. All right. So I extended an invitation on this journey, getting closer to Pops. I extended to everyone that I know and love. Shout out to everybody in the believer community that's watching right now. If you're watching God Talk, you are not watching for no reason. Please trust. Shout out to Deja, man. She gave me the most necessary call I needed yesterday. Monday after God Talk. So I appreciate y'all. Trust your experience. Be happy. Be expecting so much, man. And continue to watch. Expect a lot of me. I'm going to deliver every episode. So make sure y'all do that, man. Let me spark my weed. Hold up. Hey, if you in this bitch, make sure you send this to ping 25 people. Clubhouse is trash now. Clubhouse came and went. Everybody was feeling like instructors and professors and shit. Now nobody give a fuck about Clubhouse, man. Hey, give a fuck about yourself, man. You the only thing that ain't no fad, nigga. Yourself is the only thing that ain't no fad. Stick with yourself, man. Go harder, man. Spark your weed, man. I'ma spark my shit. Oh yeah, that's a new instrument in the background. It's Kanye, by the way. What I am gonna do real quick. Today, unfortunately, is the 2-year anniversary of losing Nipsey Hussle. It's going to be all over your gram, so I don't want to touch it too much. Pause. But what I do want to say is I remember this day, like all of us do, very distinctly. And at 6 o'clock that day, I had to be on the only hip-hop show. I had to host a radio show that we had every Sunday at Morris Media about hip-hop. We were interviewing rappers on the day that Nipsey Hussle died. It changed the entire climate and the dynamic of that interview. So I want to shout out to Black Sam that was there. I also want to shout out to my nigga C that was there as well. PC, shout out to LP, shout out to Aisha, everybody on the Only Hip Hop Show. I do want to stay consistent in this narrative because, yes, we have to mourn our losses if that's what you're into. We have to bereave, grieve, and all that stuff. What I want to say, okay, like I said on the episode of the Only Hip Hop Show, we praise a culture that is one of the most, for lack of vocabulary, toxic, dangerous, wasteful culture ever. That's what we're doing, man. And not to go back, but to go back on it, Lil Nas X said, yo, y'all mad at me now, but y'all were the ones that let y'all kids listen to Old Town Road, and I'm singing about lean in there. I'm singing about lean in Old Town Road, and we let our kids listen to it. So all I'm saying is we praise a culture that's very, very damaging to the lives of the people that we say we love. Everybody's singing about lean. Everybody's singing about Percocets. This nigga Future don't even do drugs. He has a whole song about fucking Percocets. He doesn't even do them. That's all I'm saying, man. You are what you watch. You are what you listen to. So just make sure you have a strong mind going into these things. If you're an artist, try and be a little bit more creative. Like we always talk about, the responsibility as an artist has went up. Okay, you are more responsible than you ever thought you could be. And what I want to go into real quick is something I believe is powerful because I see it in the entertainment industry. Bob talked about it. It's just the lack of integrity in the entertainment industry. And I had the pleasure of listening to Deacon Chairman Fred Hampton Jr. And a lot of the things that I say are a lot of the things that we're going to discuss today when Chev get here will be from that because that's one of our leaders. We don't really have any activists right now really, really preaching the truth and standing for something. And this is what a lot of the things that I'm going to bring to you is some of the notes that I took from that. But one of the things that he said is that so many big Hollywood companies knocked on his mother's door and offered them money, movie scripts. But all of the stories weren't accurate, or they lacked integrity, or they lacked facts, or they lacked the opportunity to inform. So he said him and his mom, they passed on so many million-dollar contracts, so many movie opportunities while their gas was off because they had to stand for truth. And then later on down the line, they get to put in the truth. They get to add in their little gems, their political pills, as what he calls it. And they were able to do that and get the money. So I'm saying all that to say, sometimes we have to take a back seat. Sometimes our career takes longer to flourish because we're full of integrity and morals. All right. We have respect for ourselves. Last week, I think I said, are you willing to trade popularity for respect? And that's a real thing. So if you're holding on to respect, if you're holding on to your integrity and you feel encouraged, please don't be. Understand there are legends walking, living, free right now who've went through and held out for more to get less than what you're wanting. All right. So make sure you're willing to sacrifice. Make sure you're holding out for the greater good. All right. And you'll get that big check. You'll get that big movie role. But just make sure you be patient. What's up, Bess? I see you out there. Chubbs, what's the deal? Shelby, what's the deal? All right. So that's my little shit. Real quick, I got a page full of shit. Let's see what we're going to do here. Got Quavo right here. Oh, quick story. Very interesting. So, yes, after I got off God Talk on Monday, I called my dad just to check in on him. If you know about last year I got back in communication with my dad. So I called him and I said, yo, Pops, how the ladies treating you out there in Boston? And he said, man, I don't give a fuck about no ladies, man. I'm like, so what do you care about? Like, and he said, I said, what do you care about? What's the best thing in your life right now? He said, and remember, this nigga 60 plus in Boston, nigga, Haitian, heavy ass, thick ass accent. He said, man, all I do is wake up and get fresh. Sometimes I got somewhere to go. Sometimes I don't got nowhere to go. But I wake up and I'm fresh every day. He also said, I got over 60 plus pair of shoes in my room. If you know me and my addiction to sneakers, amen. I just had to tell Pops, look, we ain't even got to go to Maury no more, my nigga. You the daddy. You the daddy. You my daddy, my nigga. Yeah, but he said he don't wear sneakers. He wear dress shoes. So that unpacked and sent chills up my spine. I jumped all through the fucking roof because I found out a reason why I do something I do, and it made me feel good. I say that to say two things. One, I really truly believe and encourage everyone to go buy some new shoes very soon. Very soon. Yes, the shoes are nice, but I also want you to focus on the feeling of unboxing them, putting them on, walking outside, and then going somewhere in your new shoes. It sounds cheesy, but I want you to focus on the feeling and the energy that you have, that you harness once you do that. Okay. Yes, it may be materialistic, but there's a bigger method to the madness. I want you to be able to focus on the feeling of having new shoes, focus on that feeling, and be able to replicate that feeling when you got the oldest shoes on in the world, or when the sole pops out of your shoe. I want you to make yourself feel good so you can remember the feeling, so you can use the feeling when you don't have the feeling, so you can get to the next feeling, if that makes sense. All right, just take that how it is. Go buy some fucking new shoes for yourself. Single moms, don't buy them for your kids. Buy them for you, okay? Single dads, go buy yourself some shoes, my nigga. Your son, his foot is going to keep growing. Go buy yourself some shoes, all right? I also say this. Nike has been backdooring shoes to StockX. Bro, how the fuck is StockX getting shoes months in advance and you already got a price tag on it? If the shoes ain't came out yet, if the shoes ain't made yet, who is getting and giving you these shoes? So in the sneaker community, as y'all know, I'm a huge, they call me Sneaker Sean in the hood. That's my hood name. You feel me? Nike is giving shoes to StockX early. So, and Nike is setting the resale price high, so when the shoes come out retail, they can sell out instantly. Everybody know about backdooring. That's when the niggas that work there keep the shoes for themselves, or they sell them themselves to keep the profit. So that's what's going on in the sneaker world. So niggas, we already found out the CEO of Nike was letting her son use the business card to buy up all the shit. You feel me? So Nike also, they're suing the company Mischief and Lil Nas X for making that fake ass shoe. Basically, Mischief bought all these black Air Maxes, and then they customized them, and then they sent them to all the biggest sneaker reviewers on YouTube. And then they sold the shoe for some crazy price, and then it sold out in like a minute or so. And Nike had absolutely nothing to do with it. Nike didn't design the shoe. They didn't give them the heads up. They didn't do any of that. They completely just made a custom and it sold out. Now, people make customs all the time. There's Chips Ahoy's, fucking French Toast, fucking Zelda customs, all kind of crazy shit. But this one was about Satan. And we already know how we're so willing to misunderstand and just go with whatever tells us. So a lot of people got mad about the collab between Nike, Satan, and this gay little rapper. People let him have it. And Nike don't care about somebody making Chips Ahoy cookies. You know what I'm saying? But basically, Nike is suing them. They're definitely going to win. They definitely about to get Lil Nas X getting his ass for real. And they're going to get a Mischief ass. So that's going to be interesting to see. But that's just a little something I had right there. I got so much more to unpack with y'all. I appreciate y'all for watching. I'm about to check it with these comments. Feel free to call in 424-234-9416. And then my nigga Chev is pulling up at 9:30. We about to talk about his album Spur the Moment and getting all those lyrics and crazy ass shit he going on there. I'm going to play a quick little video. And we'll be right the motherfuck back. Damn, I wonder what... I got mad videos loaded. Anyway, I'm about to play Bandemic by my nigga Chev. We'll be right the fuck back. Alexis, what's the deal?
I see you trying to offer a check. I get my own in.
Oh, this what's the deal?
Start with a scam. Cutting holes like you're trying to get a barber a hand. Like,
share the shoe plug. His name is Big Drew. Shout out Big Drew.
Here's a toast to the
shout out Big Drew, because this nigga just sent me some crazy tech. He got some crazy shit for sale right now.
We were starving and dead. Didn't fold and got on, but that was part of the plan. Like, now they know it's
Miss Davis, what's the deal, baby?
Big bro, what you want? I'm kind of caught in a jam. Tell them pros ain't going for apartments again. Getting dough, I even take the end part of the bread.
Chef said, shoe shoppers, please let's go shoe shopping. On Therapy Thursday, we can't shoe shop on work Wednesday, though.
Bro got a rollie, but it's hollow and tan. Carrot gold, he was supposed to get it solid instead. Like, playing on like a ball with the nets. Like, Blake, Kyrie, James, Harden, Durant. Niggas selling dope for a profit spin. On Big 40 Tuck, throw me in and Harley a jam. Like, running man to the bando with it. Started with grams, then I ran it up winning. 100 grand, nigga, no candy on business. Fuck a pandemic, get bands up in it. That's your man, nigga, mando snitching. Till we up cans, then this man go missing. On the dead homies, I ain't playing no nigga. Fuck a pandemic, get bands up in it. This one for the mission of the dope dealer. Pitching all that shit to the coke sniffer. Any nigga getting chip, I'm for show with ya. Reporting live, nigga, me for a loco. Plays on fire, they trying to see it in slow-mo. Make a mid a crime in HB, hella dolo. I don't give a damn how long it took, I still balled out word to LeBron hit threes from the logo. Trade lines coming free, cause I own them. Pay on time, it'll be on all the boroughs. 8-9, give me beats, I'ma fold them. Like the waistline getting squeezed by a Goro. Never starving, nigga, working with commas. Hella bars, but I'm punching no problem. Bro got chickens and I'm watching out for pig shit. But like I had a farm, nigga, worked on McDonald's. Running man to the bando with it. Started with grams, then I ran it up winning. 100 grand, nigga, no candy on business. Fuck a pandemic, get bands up in it. That's your man, nigga, mando snitching. Till we up cans, then this man go missing. On the dead homies, I ain't playing no nigga. Fuck a pandemic, get bands up in it.
It's an Englewood thing. You remember being here? You remember being here? Episode 14, my nigga. Make sure you're talking to Mike.
It's the last time the real nigga Puzo.
Damn. Okay.
Damn.
Your memory ain't that good, nigga. Stop. You remember I said you look like OBJ? You remember that?
Yeah.
Okay.
You look like Benny C.
Okay. Niggas keep saying I look like the nigga from, he played in ATL, the black nigga. The big black nigga, I don't know his name, but he ain't Godzilla. You know what I'm talking about? I don't know his name, but let me look this nigga name up.
Hell, not
the Godzilla cast, they say I look like this nigga. Everybody say I look like this nigga, bro. This should be happening hot.
You look like Uncle Ruckus.
Uncle Ruckus? Niggas be calling me that too, because I fuck with Trump. Niggas be like, this nigga look like him. Oh, shit. I'm way more fresh than Uncle Ruckus, though. Let's keep it 100. Godzilla versus Cass. Jason Weaver. No, the series. Brian Tyree Henry.
Who is that?
They say I look like this nigga
right there. Oh, who the fuck is that?
Well,
he was on ATL?
Yeah.
Doing what?
That nigga's racist. Not the T.I. movie, the shit with Childish Gambino.
Oh,
the TV show.
Paperboy.
Yeah.
And you look Atlanta.
Come on. Atlanta, yeah. Don't laugh too hard, my nigga. Watch out. Hey, if you don't know where you at, welcome back, God Talk Live. I'm your host, Shot of God Radio, Sean August, the Haitian sensation, R&B sensation, real nigga blues in your pocket right now. Got an Englewood legend. What you say? I read his books, bro. Damn, we was just talking about this too. I just read his books, bro, and I know a few things. The things I learned, it really made me fuck him.
Man, he just a beast.
Fact.
I don't even think he racist. I just think he don't give a fuck about poor people. He gives a fuck about the rich. And because, bro, I ain't gonna lie, he gave niggas money. He gave
facts.
He gave niggas money. Obama didn't give niggas money.
Gave niggas phones, though. Them Obama.
Man, and them motherfuckers break. And them motherfuckers break in 2 months, nigga. I got
ass on it.
I got out of jail, bro. Nigga, and it was no more iPhone for me for a minute. So nigga, I went to the county building and got an Obama phone. I'm like, damn, this motherfucker.
It's Frail cool. is a bitch.
I'm like, it's cool. I'm like, oh, this motherfucker cool, do the same. Nigga, 2 days later, that shit started going slow as shit. Slow as shit. I'm like, man, shout out to Obama.
Shout out to Obama, man. We could have got some free fried chicken. We could have got anything. He could have did anything for us. He signed gay rights. Facts. All right, look, we done with politics. Fuck politics. we got my nigga Chev in the building. Normally I get rude and disrespectful, ask this nigga who the fuck he is, but one, he's been on this motherfucker. I think he's my first returning guest, actually. And then second, the nigga whole intro is an interview. Oh God. So I ain't got no fucking questions for this nigga, man.
Man, shout out to the pandemic. The song and the era.
Pandemic, that's a fact.
Man, niggas was making money.
All right, so your album is called Spur of the Moment.
Spur of the Moment.
Okay, out right now.
Right now.
Everywhere in your packet.
Everywhere.
You hear me?
All on platforms.
Facts. Before we get into the album itself, let's talk about the process.
Okay, this process is that's why the album is called Spur of the Moment from Jump. Because nigga, that shit was like, we got a plan. You have a plan, like, okay, we're gonna do this A, B, C, and D, but it rarely stay like that. So what happened was, nigga, everything was off of impact, improvising, and thinking off the dome to see what we could do to make this motherfucker go when problems start. Exactly.
Okay.
Cause my motherfucker spur of the moment be like, oh shit, this function was lit. This baby shower was lit. Let's go to the function after the function, and let's go to this bar. Hey, I heard about this bar down the street from here, man. We can pull up over here. That spur of the moment.
That spur of the moment just people, yeah.
Yeah, like, oh shit, this motherfucker, this function was lit, but it was supposed to be over at 12, and then it wasn't over till 4. You feel what I'm saying? Like, that's people's spur of the moment. Nigga, my spur of the moment was, man, we got this video, and we gonna have it at such and such house, but it was technical difficulties where we couldn't have it there no more. And then it's the video is supposed to start in an hour and 30 minutes, but we don't have a location to the location that we want to do this certain situation at. Like,
I'm following you.
And now we just running around like a chicken with his head cut off, but we end up plotting up before the hour 30 minutes is over, we find another location. Now, and then the motherfucking video is fire. You feel what I'm saying? It come out fire for the situation. We had our antennas clicking, and then we found the location, and it was a better location than the other spot. You feel what I'm saying? That's our spur of the moment.
So are you saying that tell God your plans, he'll laugh at you. All that shit is not going to go how you plan.
That's fact.
Then when it goes terrible, keep your mind right, and the shit is going to go way better than you expect it to go.
Exactly, because you still got to complete the mission that you had, your plan. You got to complete that.
You still got to go.
Your plan still got to go as planned, but it doesn't go the way you think it's going to go. It's going to go as planned. Like nigga, I'm going to get to start to finish. That's your plan. I'm going to start from start, and then I'm going to finish that shit.
Facts.
But where you think you're going to go in the meantime is not going to be how you thought it was. You feel
talk that shit.
Yeah.
It's a million ways to get to your destination. It's a million ways, nigga. Freeways, streets, nigga. Exactly. Uber, scooter, walk, bus. It's a million ways.
And then you think that you think you got your car, and your car about to get you to your destination, and be like, damn, then your car break down. Now you got to call Uber. You gotta call
facts.
Uber, or nigga, your Uber ain't working though. Your Uber, nigga, your phone fucking up. So now you gotta add Lyft, cause you don't got Lyft. You got
come
Uber.
On now, use
so
all
now
the
you
resources.
Gotta add Lyft, you
just
you
to go to one place.
Just to go to one place. Boom, you get there. Boom. Now as soon as you get there, it's finna close on you. Your location finna close, but you get the motherfucker to let you in. I don't know what you said to him, but you completed your mission. But it wasn't just like, oh, I'm gonna get there and I'm gonna drive in my car. Nigga, your car you still gotta wait for your car to get towed from when it broke down. So now, nigga, you at your location, but you still on the phone with the motherfucker tow people, yes, sir, woo, like you, but you still made it to your location. You still did it.
Talking to the mic.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Okay.
You can pull it in. Yeah.
But yeah, like, so like you still did it though. You still did your, you still made it to your destination. You still completed your mission, but.
And you didn't learn some shit. Mm-hmm. And you didn't learn how to work your resources. You didn't learn how to work Uber now. You probably didn't got a free the first ride free.
Yeah.
You know how it go. You start realizing your blessings and your extra resources when you start using the ones you already got. So I appreciate that, nigga. And that was a perfect explanation, my nigga. I was not expecting that. But what I can say about your album specifically, because one, I needed it because I needed a soundtrack to work out. It's not too much workout music, bro. And I have to work right now. I'm on a challenge. I'm working out for 100 straight days.
That's right.
And I'm on 84. Today's 84, bro. Damn. So I always challenge myself. I'm always challenging myself to do some crazy shit. That's so right. I needed your album. You feel me? And when it dropped, soon as I played it, the first song, it gave me Carter One vibes.
Yeah.
From the highest respect, bro. It gave me Carter One vibes. It sounds just like
that,
what is this song called? Fly In, I think it's called. And nigga, through the rest of the album, nigga, is high energy, bro. I got some notes in here. But I heard high energy. Nigga, you have some sports references in there. Of course, that's what we're going to... Let's stay there. Let's stay there because it's some shit going on right now. Fuck. Shout out to Quavo. All right.
I just seen that video last night, bro.
Yeah. Shout out to everybody previous, before and after, that's getting riled up and reacting to a point where their career is on the line. I'm not even going to say the extra details because I'm tired of talking about this same situation. But what we got to do is find a way. So you got a lot of sports references in. I saw KD coming at Michael Rappaport, calling this nigga a bitch and a cunt, and he'll spit on him and shit. Hey, bro, so just, I'm not even going to say black man. I'm just saying, as a man, I really, really suggest that we do a way better job controlling our emotions, our sensitivity, and our reaction. So I just said that. You speak your mind on it.
Man, bro, we trying to learn that, bro. Like me, bro, I be on some... Sometime I get to where I be on some firecracker shit, nigga.
Facts.
I'll act... This one broad, she was a whole bitch. You can find out... You can learn a lot from prostitutes. This one bitch, like, you work on a glitch. And I was like, what? She like, you work on a glitch and you need to work on that. You react on a glitch, like you work on a glitch, and you need to work on that. And I'm like, bitch, you got me fucked up. Go prostitute that bitch. Go sell some, because it was the homie. It's the homie, bitch. Like, yeah. Man, bitch, go. Where the next track at, bitch? Let's get it. But nigga, when I got Dolo, when I was Dolo, I analyzed that. I'm like, man. And I just thought about that situation with what she said. And I'm like, man, that's true. Like, but I'm where I'm getting to is motherfuckers react on shit that they don't have to react on. You feel what I'm saying?
Talk your shit.
They nigga, you act on a glitch, nigga. It's like, that's, you don't think about what you do, you just do it.
TTG.
And sometimes in every aspect and situations, that shit ain't cool. Like, so nigga, I'm learning that as well as we go right now. You feel what I'm saying? Like, that shit is critical and important, most important to know, nigga. You cannot fuck your life up off a temporary moment. Like, you feel what I'm saying? Yo, especially your career, and it's booming. You know, sometimes basketball players, they can come back off they shit because they play sports. You feel what I'm saying? But entertainers, that shit'll fuck your whole world, because really your image, like, it's they skills that keep them, that basketball players keep. But it's like we cousins. Rappers and basketball players, they look like kind of cousins. Like, we want to be them, they want to be us.
At the sleepovers.
You feel what I'm saying? You feel what I'm saying? So, But basketball players, they can more normally keep their career because their skills, that's what is what we worry about. They can still shoot the three. They injuries is what fucks them up. But rappers and entertainers and actors, they fuck they shit up because that'll end a nigga career off of 30 seconds of video. You feel what I'm saying?
Right.
Because nigga, the image is what we look at the rappers and the entertainers like, oh shit, he's this way and he looks like this, so that'll fuck us up. So yeah, I'm learning the same exact thing you saying, like, man, cause I ain't gonna lie, nigga, I can act off a situation and be like, nigga,
start
bitch
glitching.
Talking crazy, a nigga talking crazy. You feel what I'm saying? You gotta like think in certain situations, like, you feel me? even on shit like how motherfuckers be like, I was watching a Drake interview. That nigga said his mama told him like he gave him a 72-hour rule for 3 days, basically. Like, give him 72-hour rule of what you want to do on situations. Like, not probably every situation, but try to put that, feel me? Like, some shit be like, nah, you already know shit just in black and white. But some shit you really don't know and you having a feeling off of it, you know, give yourself time to think about shit and analyze it and go over it again. You feel what I'm saying? 72 hours is a long time to think about some shit. And you'll be able to come up with a conclusion off of 72 hours. You feel what I'm saying?
Niggas take 72 seconds. We already blood
it's
on
up.
Our temp.
It's up. And it's stuck. Nigga, 72 seconds. Slap. Wop, wop.
We and you can't go back.
Nah, you can't come. You can't go back when sometime that person may need to right his wrongs on his own.
Mm. Who are you, nigga?
Man, bro. Cool nigga for Eaglewood, nigga.
We got a motherfucking call, man.
Fuck with it.
Call from.
I think they said Bishop. Thank you for calling God Talk Timmy. Excuse me.
How's it going? It's Bishop Brooks again. I just want to chime in a little bit. I enjoy what you guys are talking about. You know, I kind of like the realness.
God.
And how you guys are just really just expressing things that I think is really highly significant. I just wanted to kind of touch on a little bit, you know what I'm saying, about what young man was talking about as far as when, you know, we react from, I would consider emotions instead of rationalizing, you know, because most of the time men, when it comes to men, we were created to rationalize. Mm-hmm.
Speak.
You know, oftentimes we get caught up and we allow, you know, our emotions to drive us and then we make decisions. And most of the time we're getting something and 5 minutes that'll take us 20 years to get out of it.
Literally.
Hell, because we don't really take the time to really rationalize the situation, analyze it, and look at the ramification that may come from it.
Yeah, so, and I discovered the reactory mind or the emotional mind processes information faster than the rational one.
They do.
The rational one takes a couple more seconds. It's fast too, but it takes a couple more seconds. Go ahead, Bishop.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. You know, when you're dealing with the soul, like, you know, I do a lot of teaching on, you know, psychology and things of that nature. And so, you know, your soul is a collective of, like, five psychological indexes, your mind, imagination, emotion, intellect, and will. And so a lot of times when I deal with the part of just reacting to something, if you don't really take the time to really analyze what will happen and what's going to come from it, and you react, and which is kind of hard to do most of the time unless you really train yourself. I've learned that. Yeah, I learned most of the things that come from your subconscious mind. A lot of these things come from really what it basically comes from your upbringing. So a lot of times you're reacting, then you're like, why did I do that? You know, and later on down the line, you ask yourself why. But a lot of stuff is launching your subconscious mind needs to be eradicated. And you know, going through the process of taking things out of your subconscious mind so you won't act out certain characters that you're really going to be acting out.
You preach.
So, you know. That's like a process of learning, but I really enjoy you guys and the things that you guys are talking about.
Man, I appreciate what you just said. You feel what I'm saying? Like, you have to like really like police yourself to do some
facts.
Shit. You really like gotta like rearrange your mind, unlearn. That nigga Derek Gray say unlearn and relearn.
Facts. You have to.
Yeah, like I appreciate what you just said, like, cause. That's years and your mind is programmed for years and years. Reprogrammed. That's what I was trying to say.
Mm-hmm.
You got your mind is programmed for years and years and years and years to think like that. You said emotions. Your emotions take over because it's the way you feel. It's how you feel. That should make you sad, make you mad in an instant, and now you acting off feelings. Sometimes you got to separate from how you feel and what's real.
You a rapper?
That's cold, huh? That's cold.
Hey, nigga, got an album out or some shit?
Hey, I got that from ATL. I ain't gonna lie, nigga. Uncle George, nigga.
Shout out to Uncle George, man.
Shout out Uncle
Bishop,
George.
I appreciate you for calling, man. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to tap in. I need your hoodie size, nigga.
Niggas didn't think. Go ahead.
No, I need your hoodie size. Make sure you DM me your hoodie size so I can get that for you.
Oh, yeah, I did. I did inbox you the last time. I didn't really get a response yet, but yeah, I definitely.
That's on me. Hey, call us, send her out, Pastor. Don't worry about that. I got you. I appreciate you calling.
All right. God bless you guys.
God bless you too. Damn, sorry for the R&B music, but you said you about to sing? Freestyle R&B right now. Let's go. Talk to that dirty bitch right now. Let's go. Some pussy last night. Let's stop capping. The nigga sing that. This nigga started off hitting the high notes. He started off.
Hey, I'm trying to hit the notes, bruh. Hey, them high notes give you C notes, bruh. Everybody wanna listen to singing right now, bruh.
High notes all of, get you C notes.
All of hip hop right now is all the hip hop niggas rapping. All the rappers is rap. Singing right now. It's singing. Dirt, YB, Kodak. All the niggas that's influential and hard right now, Young Thug, they all rapping and singing.
Niggas calling me? Is it me or is it you? Is it ODB or Beanie Siegel?
Mike Mang.
My dog, D&G, gang in here.
D&G, God talk to me.
Man, what it do, man?
This nigga in bed still. Facts.
Nah, I ain't in bed. I'm waking. I'm waking niggas up,
make
sure niggas get to you, man.
Hey, sir. Like that, man.
I'm making sure the business get done.
Yeah, business gonna get handled, fucking with Mike D, man.
Man, what it do, though, man? Like, damn, I'm proud of you, my man.
Man, good luck.
I'm proud of you, too, my man.
Man, it's a together thing. You already know.
But, yeah, man, I just have to call in, nigga, put my energy in the room one time.
Man, good God talk. Good God talk.
I appreciate you, nigga.
Man, it's been a nigga. Niggas don't know, nigga. Well, nigga, 2016, nigga. I was in the walls, nigga. Mm. I was in the walls, nigga. Only person I'm calling in, nigga, Mike Maine, nigga. What you on, nigga? I'm at Nordstrom's, nigga. I'm at Nordstrom's with it, nigga. Niggas ain't know, nigga. Niggas ain't know them days, fool. Oh God,
like that, nigga. You be working, bro, and I really appreciate you. You really remind me of Irv Gotti.
I put on weight like bro too.
Not you, nigga. This nigga Mike Maine look like Irv Gotti head ass, nigga. Fuck out of here. This nigga like, nigga, yeah, I am Irv Gotti. I appreciate you, Mike Maine, nigga. You already know. Continue to rep, nigga. Inglewood all day, nigga.
That was funny as fuck.
Smack this nigga Smith. Tell him get up out of bed, nigga. We waiting on that album.
Boy, it's on the way.
Hey, y'all, man, Smith coming back crazy. I just say that right now.
We
man.
Got a little bang. Coming we got me. Crazy. Me and Smith got a banger on the way. Just know
that. Yeah, it's up, bro. I'm telling you right now. Nigga, you the first one to know, bro.
Say less. Smith, you know where I'm at. Crazy. You know how I'm at. Where we at. We family, man. Anytime, every time. I appreciate you, brother.
We already know.
All right. Mike, man, DNG, grow. Of course, we got my nigga Fo Loco Chev on this motherfucker. If y'all don't know the narrative, last week I said we have a responsibility to do for those who can't. Specifically, I was referencing working out because I'm doing a burpee challenge, by the way. Yeah. So during my burpees, I plateau. And it's right around the time a certain song come on. I'm about to have him go to it. And in a second, I'm going to have him drop to it. I'm going to play it and everything. But I just want to say, encourage everybody, man, when you get to that plateau, when you get to that time when you tired, just think about that person who can't get that burpee in, dude. Think about that person in the wheelchair. Think about that person who ain't got the body, who ain't got the limbs. Yo, think about it. I seen a nigga hooping with one arm dunking on niggas, bro.
I seen that shit, too.
You feel me?
I seen that on the gram.
Wes B is standing up DJing for hours, bro, on brand new ankles. So you have the responsibility to go harder. We have to up the ante in more levels than one. Artists, working out mentally, our communication, our relationships, we have to up the ante. And when I plateau during this workout, no stimmy comes on. Shout out to Spur of the Moment. Shout out to this nigga Chev. When I plateau, when I'm like, man, why the fuck did I sign up for this? No stimmy hits. The beat fire, the vocals, the tone, The energy is fired. I don't know who's featuring on that nigga. It's hilarious. But I just want to say I fuck with this song, and I need you to explain it and then go to it. I'm gonna play.
No Stimmy or New Stimmy?
New Stimmy? Is it New Stimmy?
New Stimmy got the feature.
I think. No. Then it's No. Oh, I'm glad you explained that. Then I got No Stimmy. Then yeah.
Okay, so
it's No Stimmy for sure.
What? It ain't no feature on there.
Yeah, it's no feature.
Yeah, that shit. Okay, so No Stimmy. Okay, so I got two things to say. Okay, so that's a cold logic. How you think, like, do it for, think about the people who can't do, who not able to do what you're doing right now.
Yeah.
That's a cold logic. Cause yeah, that'll get you a long way. Cause your mind will reprogram like, all right, second win. Like, yeah, okay, I get it. Okay. All right. Let me get in motion. Cause you'd be like, damn, that motherfucker really can't do it. And I can really walk
right now.
I can really walk. Yeah. So anyway, and my music, it's kind of like that, like the way you said, like how No Stimmy came on for you, like nip music, like wherever I gotta do something, put some responsibility on my name. Nip music will motivate me because that nigga just talk about he actually give you the game from A to Z on exactly what to do in the streets, as a man, you know, in everything, in business, nigga, jugging. He tell you exactly how, what you're supposed to do, how you act. So that music, his music is what does that for me. And so I'm trying to do that. He teaches you the game. I'm only giving you my story. And my story is what.
Well said.
Yeah. So my story is, you feel what I'm saying? The game. I'm in the, I make a dollar out of 15 cent. And you feel what I'm saying? I'm in the streets. I'm trying to do business, handle business with this rap shit. I'm learning. I done been to jail. I done walked the main line. I done did a whole lot. You feel what I'm saying? I done fucked up. I done did some fucked up shit.
Bounce back,
yeah,
for sure.
You feel what I'm saying? You gotta right your wrongs on that. Like, yeah. It's not all, it's sometimes the only shit I think that is you can't come back from is snitching and turning, and
you can definitely come back from snitching.
You can't come back.
6ix9ine came back from snitching.
Yeah.
He came back from snitching. That nigga record still going number one. But go ahead.
His record not going number one no more. That his album did even do 50K in the first week. Like,
we seen that before.
Yeah, but yeah,
you, but yeah, I'm with you. Snitching that. And you said what else?
And a real street hood nigga turning gay. Like being gay, like that shit that happened with the suck a dick dude, like you can't come back from that.
Yeah, I heard about that late. Yeah.
You can't come back from that. You feel what I'm saying? So them the two things. But other than that, like, you feel what I'm saying? For the most part, you can right your wrongs. You feel what I'm saying? It's a thing of apologies.
Hmm.
And it's, you feel what I'm saying? You could come back from that shit. But other than that, that's what I'm saying. You can right your wrongs on shit. Oh, I forgot what was that. That was
No Stimmy.
Oh yeah, like
no, nigga, everything was perfectly said. Bro.
Oh God. So what God I was talk. Getting to is I that's what I do for, that's what my music is. I'm trying to be motivational because shit. I got
job well
to
done.
Say.
Yep. Job well done, nigga. You got me through. So go ahead and drop it, nigga. We going to No Stimmy right now.
Yeah, this No Stimmy from off the album Spread a Moment. It's out right now on everything off platform. Yeah, No Stimmy.
There's No Stimmy.
Stop playing with these niggas.
This nigga ain't got time to look at the track, that's why I'm dripping in sweat, making that body cry, nigga. That's a real thing.
Walked in with some B-dogs in your apartment, boy. Nigga reppin' Eagles till I'm sleepin' a coffin door. All I get is green, but if it's deep,
appreciate
then I'm on it,
watching.
Boy. I'll instantly
make
go
sure
from
y'all
being a
favorite
carnivore.
Emojis. The Cash
Sweet
app
nuts,
is
niggas,
right below.
All enjoy.
My
so
nigga Chev on
CP9,
the left, sending your offer, man. Everything
he
going straight to him.
CC,
you hear me? That's
Michael
how we do it.
When it copped the Beamer, it was free off the FICO score. The M3 jugged the pink, that was adios. Copped the 223 nice, swinging like Bomino. This EDD got us drinking that 1942 in Casamigos like it's PC, I'm buying a star. Take a ZZ to AT&T, have them bop this throat and gay the ZZ. I ate the weed, then I'm dropping them off. Now I got max and PC, but I'll swap them, no. Now I got packs of good peas and I got them for low.
What else?
He might be, yeah, that's folks. Never folded on me. You nigga break the cold. Little Brody, a cold informant. I be in the cut, but the homie trying to run up on you. Find a death in the four, Kobe out of Yoshinoya. Listen to this beat, thinking it's hella fire. Thought about a feature, nigga, real winning 7-5. Shit was 7-5, I can make that shit 7 times. I ain't telling lies, catching packs, I think I'm Megatron.
What else?
Then I throw him back, I think I'm Patrick at the Reds online. Or Lamar Jack with Mark Andy, shit, and be a fire.
What else?
Just got the sack, I'm on Brian, her locker time. About to run that shit up fast, better recognize. Bitch, I kicks in FIFA, featuring Tekken 9. I can feed him with these sticks on a Tekken 9. I'll come clean up off the hip, upper echelon. Glock release, broken, simple like Tekken shot.
Airdrop it to me. Airdrop it to my MacBook. I put it on. No stimmy. I know niggas is out of that stimmy right now. How much more of that stimmy you got left? I need to know how much of that stimmy you got left. I probably got like 40. I got an eighth left.
Nigga, I didn't get my
stimmy. That stimmy gone as fuck. 1400 ain't nothing to a real nigga. That is barely rent, nigga. You got me fucked up. You hear me? But I appreciate any extra and all extra abundance life we do live.
Airdrop on.
Yeah. I'm about to try some new shit. I hope I don't fuck shit up.
My stimmy went to my kids, man.
Shout out to the kids. I cashed out my kids the other day. I'm like, son, how much money you guys been running low off the V-Bucks?
That shit gonna kill a nigga.
Nigga running low off the V-Bucks.
You heard? Oh, V-Bucks? That shit mandated. That shit mandatory. I go broke on that shit, but it's this new shit called Apex. You heard play Apex?
Hell no.
Nigga.
A game?
Yeah, it's like Fortnite. And the only reason I know is I got a young, that nigga game on as fuck. They got this shit. It's like a if Call of Duty and Fortnite had a baby. And they fucking made Apex, and motherfuckers play games. They know what I'm talking about. I don't even really know what I'm talking about.
I'm really a Madden nigga. Like, I've been smacking.
That's all I mean.
I've been smacking niggas in Madden since I was a mute.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Smacking niggas.
Running niggas.
Who your team?
Ravens. I've been a Ravens fan since Jamal Lewis. I'm not a bandwagon.
No, I respect it. Either way, you are. So you got some planning to do. All right. So is Lamar Jackson who he say he is, or is he a?
I'm gonna keep it all the way bright with niggas. So Lamar Jackson is a black running back. He's a runner. He gonna run before he pass. And this my team, nigga. So when we got him, it was like, oh shit, like, you know. But it's just like every other black quarterback. Like, the nigga is just better than the hardest black quarterback. But you can stop that, because they end up next year, nigga, it gets easier to tame, because they go back, look at the tapes, and see what he does, how he does it. But he's still that's why he's still getting, but he's a black quarterback. When Cam Newton came in.
Shot. Before I shot Cam Newton out, I'm going to start screaming in a second. All right. But you shot out New England. I heard New England. I left this here for you. You shout out New England on the album, and you shout out Tom Brady on the album.
Yeah.
I don't know if you did that intentionally because you are a fan secretly.
Nah, I'm a football fan.
Or you just know greatness when you see it.
Yeah. The number two. Number two. Hell yeah, number two. That nigga Kobe Bryant. You don't bet against Kobe. Even if he loses.
Let's not take it too far. Let's stay on Tom Brady.
Tom Brady is Kobe in over there. He went to a whole nother team. He like Jordan. He went to a whole nother
team. Now we can talk.
What's the difference between Jordan and Kobe?
Oh, man. Nothing, man. They're the same person.
Jordan couldn't play. Jordan, I don't think Jordan. It was a bunch of Jordans in when Kobe was playing. Like, not as a GOAT, but just the way they play. Like, it was more of, nigga. Yeah. Finesse, nigga.
And Kobe was just the best
niggas.
Jordan.
When Jordan was balling, it wasn't a lot of him doing that. Like, it wasn't Allen Iverson.
Revolutionary.
It wasn't Allen Iverson, nigga, in his prime. It was Allen Iverson's rookie, and that was really the only nigga that was really crossing shit. It's every nigga in the NBA is crossing shit, nigga. Nigga, every in nigga in the NBA know how to do some shit, know how to step back, nigga. It's a lot. It's nigga James Harden, Kyrie, nigga. It's nigga the Nets they self, nigga KD. It wasn't that when Jordan was playing.
Agreed.
So Kobe was playing in that.
Shitting
era.
On Jordan's air? Are you shitting on Jordan's air right now? Yeah, are you doing that?
Yes. Not. I'm not shitting.
Charles Collins.
They was balling, but they was the first ones to do it. But when Jordan took over. But then he left. But then if it was a lot of hims, Kobe did that when it was a lot of hims. Like a lot.
Yeah, he was the best nigga to act it was like Jordan. Like,
yeah.
But that's why I don't like it.
It was T-Mac, Vince Carter. It was a lot of niggas coming. Like, they would have gave Jordan a run for him. He wouldn't probably won every time he came. Hey, man.
Give me AI. Give me Jordan AI Braun, man. I respect Kobe. Like, Kobe's in there. Like, he has to be in there, but I ain't got to mention him. Right?
What the fuck?
Can we talk about Spur?
You said you speaking on AI? You speak on AI before Jordan? Kobe?
Jordan, AI, and King.
Kobe shitted on AI. Don't,
let's not be disrespectful. Let's not be disrespectful.
Call from
Slippery Lips.
Slippery Lips.
Send a voicemail.
Slippery Lips. God talk to me.
How you doing?
Good. So grateful. How are you?
I'm fine.
Go ahead.
I just heard that track y'all just played with Chev. I just wanted to know where you got the inspiration to fit that.
Shit. That was crazy. So I do metal. I be on some metaphors bar. Every bar got to be hard. But then I'm just thinking about it like, damn. Maybe I should just go in, stop thinking about that shit. Just go in, talk that spicy shit. Like, stop thinking about it. And shit, I just was talking about facts, what I was doing, what I would be doing in the street, what I'll be on. Like,
waiting on that stimmy.
Yeah. Nah, it's called no stimmy. It's called no stimmy because I'm talking about getting money. Facts. I'm just talking about getting money. And nigga, I ain't waiting. I ain't worried about my
no stimmy.
Yeah, so my stimmy is gonna come when it come, but yeah, that was the inspiration from just talk that spicy shit, talk that shit that I know what nigga talk that facts, and it was easier. That was one of the easiest songs I did. That shit was fast, and it came out a banger.
I believe you. I like it.
You could twerk to it.
You said what? He was some shit.
Yeah, I can feel
you on
that Yo Chanel part right there. How you made it to the restaurant? I like that part.
Hey, it was crazy. Damn, I forgot this song. It's a video. We coming out with a video on Friday. Everybody, you got it first. You got it first. I'm gonna show you off air and shit, but you got it. You heard it first.
Or we could premiere it first. You can airdrop it if you want. But go ahead.
Okay, we gonna figure it out after this call. Yup. But yeah, the Yo Chanel shit. That's a bar. I said. Fly as fuck in a foreign Kobe out of Yoshinoya.
Yeah. That one right there, I can definitely relate to. That's why I said I gotta let him know. That part, that bar is too hot right there. It's too hot.
Yeah, I appreciate it for sure.
Okay, then I was just calling in to get my little piece right there. Y'all keep it pushing.
Thank you, yeah, thank Slippery you. Lips.
That's your Instagram.
I'll hit you up later. Bye.
Sliding them DMs.
I don't know who that is. You know what that is?
That's Slippery Lips. She called for you, nigga.
Damn.
It's people watching.
Oh, that's cool. Oh God.
I see on this motherfucker. What's the deal? Let me get some shout outs. When is bitch? Michael, what's the deal? Cass, what's the deal? Alexis, what's the deal? Deja, what's the deal? I appreciate y'all for tuning in. Of course, God Talk Live. Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 9 a.m. This nigga up right now. It's a lot of niggas up.
Oh, God, I'm up.
Niggas is up.
This normal. This normal be up like this.
Don't say less.
Because, shit, what? You be missing shit. You got to get in out here. You got to get out here and see the light. See life. Like, nigga. You know the rest. You want me to airdrop no stimmy? Alright. Yeah, though. That's every day.
Alright.
Niggas be laid up and shit. They ain't doing shit.
And them days is cool, too.
This album is not for you.
Just not all the time. No, this album is definitely, nigga, you gotta be sweating.
Yeah, you gotta be. Sometimes you be like, I don't wanna do shit. Yeah. I'm not doing shit.
Facts.
You be getting, motherfuckers be calling you. You be mad. They be mad. Like, we got business to handle. But
just chill. Just don't be so hard on yourself, man. Sometimes it's okay to do nothing. We have the time. We have the ability to do nothing right now. But so take advantage of it.
You got to do that like once every 2 months type shit.
Nah, you could do it a couple times. Sometimes I read Russell Simmons wrote a book called Success and Stillness. Like, so you probably like every week I got therapy Thursday. Like tomorrow, like today's work Wednesday. So I'm not leaving this room, nigga. Like, I'm gonna go work out hard, nigga. Uh-huh. And I'm coming right here, and I'm not leaving this motherfucker till nighttime, nigga. Till I'm done. And then tomorrow, I just chill.
Okay,
I relax. Go get a fucking massage and get my nails done. That's my haircut day. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I just terrify.
Right.
Theritate. Right. You know what I'm saying? And Friday, I turn up, nigga. So, y'all know, the believers know, Money Monday, Training Tuesday, add skills or better the skills you have. Then Work Wednesday, put them fucking skills to use. Therapy Thursday.
I fucks with that.
It's easy.
It's like you got to have a consistent work. But sometimes it be like, you got work Monday, work Tuesday, work Wednesday, work Thursday, and then you might have to do something on Friday, but it ain't work. It's just like you got to handle it.
Yeah.
But then, like for me, it just be like, oh, you got this to do on Monday, you got this to do on Tuesday, you got. I don't think I never had them days. So when I have a day like I don't want to do shit, I still be having shit to do. Like, I always have shit to do.
Always. Every time you sit down, it's like, damn, especially when you're independent and doing everything for yourself. Of course, we got our support. We can't do nothing without our support. But when you know what you need to do, when you sit your ass down, sometimes you feel guilty. You know, like, God damn, I didn't do. Oh, God damn. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But it's a gift and a curse. But either way, nigga, if we doing it, just be grateful. Embrace the times you got to work. Embrace the times you get to rest. Exactly.
You got to have chill days.
And plan accordingly.
On God.
Facts.
Yeah, on God.
I wrote this shit down, so I want to get this off perfectly. Because again, I watched Chairman Fred Hampton Jr. just speak, and the nigga speaks so fast. He from Chicago, so nigga, I really only understood like 70% of what he said, but the 70% was so unforgettable. Yeah. Niggas forget 50% of what you say off the rip anyway. Yeah. So, you know what I'm saying? So I just want to preface this question to you. I'm gonna shut the fuck up, and then I just want you to expound on it as much as you can. I'm gonna just read all my notes right here, and then you just take it how you take the notes how you want. All right. Working for money. Again, I said that because Fred Hampton and his mom, what they were getting, because you know they just put out the Judas and the Messiah movie, which is a great movie about Fred Hampton, and he said before this movie was shot, Every movie company was throwing millions at them and their gas was off. Keep in mind, this is Fred Hampton's son and his wife. Their gas was off. And he said they turned down millions after millions after millions, book deals after movie deals after all kind of deals, interview deals, you know, just because it lacked integrity or it lacked in truth or it lacked accuracy. Or he said one of the scripts made the white cop, it glorified the white cop, like it got into the white cop's life, and you know what I'm saying.
Oh.
And he had to pass on, but their gas was off. He was taking cold showers. But anyway, and then the homie told me, he said he lost, somebody told him, like the lady told you, and Paul, somebody also said, shout out Deja, she said sometimes the best messages come from conversations that she had from people. But shout out to Cedo, shout out to Millennial Mindset Podcast. But he said money is a byproduct of success, meaning don't work for money, work for success. Work for, I'm not sure, I guess success is subjective.
It's a byproduct for success, like you can use it. Like you can use money to get successful.
Yeah, I wanted to open that up to you and see how you said it. But again, working for money, I want you to expand on that and break that down compared to working for success, if you can. That's my question.
Yeah, shit. I'm still trying to, okay, because that's an interesting topic, because he's saying work for money, but then he said money is a byproduct of success. Mm-hmm. So I'm thinking what that mean is you can use money to get successful. Like you can work for get your own money, because if you have to work to get to accumulate some money to do something else with it, then that's just what you have to do mm-hmm. at that time for that time frame. Like his intentions on and his feelings on how that's them a key word, movies what you said. Them movies was trying to come at him and shit, and people was coming at him off with all this money. It's like integrity to his dad, and that's like real deep. So mm-hmm. I'm feeling like he just like not finna take these millions, because this is deeper than that. Like that was some shit. You feel what I'm saying? Like, so I feel like he wasn't taking that, them millions, because that was a big thing in his, I think he would be, he felt like he was, he'd be disowning, not disowning,
dishonoring
his dad. You feel what I'm saying? Like, but if you have to work for a few, like working for money, sometime a nigga have to get a job, you feel what I'm saying? But you're not trying to, you're not trying to stay in that situation, you feel what I'm saying? I had to get a job. Like, I got a job, and then I stacked like 3-4 checks. Like, it's a mind thing. Somebody said, like, nigga, if you feel like that's what you got to do, I stacked 4 of my checks, and then I went to work. I did my shit with my 4 checks after that, you feel what I'm saying? I never looked back at a job. So, That's a different situation. You feel what I'm saying? Work. So if you working for money, meaning, I think he mean like you're working for the next man, and you working for him and making his success big, because money is a byproduct. But he said money is a byproduct, meaning money, he's buying you. This guy that you working for, he buying you to make his success bigger. Like he using his product, he using this money because it's a necessity in the world. But in your mind, you like, he gonna give this to me and I'm gonna be able to do this and do that, pay my bills and this and that. That's your mindset. So he like, he thinking like, he probably thought like later down the road, I mean, before he had his job, that, oh, I'm gonna use my money and then I'm gonna pay these people, like the person you working for, I'm gonna pay her and I'm gonna make her work for me for my business, and my shit gonna get successful. So he thinking low-key how I'm thinking, like, shit, I'm going to get my money from this little job. I'm going to put it together, and then I'm going to make something happen. Like,
invest in this. Pay this little $22 an hour real quick so I can get that back in.
Exactly.
Like, and get them tax breaks and them SBAs.
Yeah, but you ain't thinking about your on God, get my business going and make my shit boom. But if you thinking like, oh, I'm going to get this check, and then I'm going to feed my family. Of course you got to do that, but I'm gonna spend my whole check. I'm not gonna save none of it on bills, and I'm spending on my kids, and you're gonna do that regardless. But you're gonna rationalize your money. You're gonna save some of that shit.
Gotta stack. Gotta have something to hold on.
You gotta figure it the fuck out, because that's exactly what you.
They
gotta
said
do.
All the companies that went belly up in the pandemic was the ones that didn't have any savings. Those are the only ones that caved in. But I want to break down what you said, and I think it's key to, because I didn't know how to tie it in, you know, and I was looking for answers, and the
from
answer
that,
you
from
gave
that statement?
Me. Yeah. And because I didn't know how to tie it in. So I'm glad you said what you said. And the key word that stood out to me was intention. So all my entrepreneurs, anybody that's breathing, don't let the intent of your service or your product that you're selling or giving away be money. Don't let that, I'm about to drop this record to get a record deal because I'm about to get this $1 million check and go buy my mama a house. Bro, one, that's not how the game goes, and you need to get well more studied. All right. But don't let the intention of you being a chef, don't let the, in any business that you're in, don't let the intention be the money. Even if you at work right now, like somebody told
you
me.
Stop.
Yeah.
You stop. Once you get the money, you're going to, if you get the money, because there's a possibility you could get the money, the shit that you're doing it for, and you have a talent to get the money. Boom, you get it. You're gonna stop.
It's a byproduct. It's a byproduct. It come with the game.
Cause it's like you got the money, and now okay, what I'm about to do with this money? It's supposed to be a byproduct.
Facts.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's making sense. It's making sense.
It's making more sense.
It's making more sense the way we unpack it. Don't let the intent be. Again, I want to highlight, don't let the intent be money, okay? Don't take that deal just because your gas is off.
Yeah.
All right, let the intent be the integrity and the belief in your product, in your album, in your fucking makeup line, in anything that you're doing. Make sure your intent is to deliver. My intent for this show is to make everyone's life as effortless as possible. That's what everyone's purpose, that's what God's purpose, God talk. Lowercase g, that's what we are, but that's what our job is. That's what your purpose is, to make, help out your niggas, man. Help out your bros, help out your sis, your kids, your every, help, bro. That's what it is. Make somebody's life effortless. And if you're an entrepreneur, make sure your products reflect that. If you're a rapper, make sure the responsibility went up. He's telling his story. He said his story resonated. He already helped me get through my fucking day. I think it was day 81 through day 80. I think it was day 80 through 83. I was banging this nigga shit. Pause his album. I was playing Spur at the moment consistently while I'm doing my burpees. You feel me? So continue to do yourself. Do what you do, and it's gonna make sure it will help the person that you're trying to do, even if it's only one person. It's gonna help.
Hey,
sorry if I said all kind of gay shit in there.
that was so gay. I was trying to keep it in.
Yeah, no, I'm the pause king. You hear me? Like, get the pause out. You hear me? Because it's really about motherfucking. God. It's really about fucking vocabulary, the lack of vocabulary. But it pause is hilarious. But hey, I'm about to go to. Yeah,
I appreciate that though. Like, nigga, like that's what I'm doing it for. I mean, I'm not doing it for. Exactly to inspire people, but I'm telling my story, and if it applies to you,
yeah.
Then that shit, that's a good thing, bro. It's a good feeling.
Yeah, you tell your story vivid,
like,
nigga.
Yeah, for sure, and the motherfucker could relate to that shit. Like it's like, oh shit, all right, this is what I'm doing.
You love Inglewood too.
Hell yeah.
You love Inglewood. I'm going to go to Bandemic, and then I'm going to get this video queued up. We're going to play that, man. I appreciate all the believers for tapping in, man. We ain't sure. Going nowhere just yet. We'll be right the fuck back. Bandemic, man. My nigga, Chev.
I see Joe tryna offer a check. I get my own and it only really start with a scam. I'm cutting holes like they're trying to get a barber a hand. Like, here's a toast to the losses we had. When they didn't know us, they was trying to charge an arm and a leg. I remember we was low and we was starving to death. Didn't fold and got on, but that was part of the plan. Like, now they know us, so they call me like Chef. Big bro, what you want? I'm kind of caught in a jam. Tell them pros ain't going for apartments again. Getting dough, I even take the end part of the bread. Like, who this nigga that you calling your mans? Think he own, but he broke and he be borrowing pants. Bro got a rollie, but it's hollow and tin. Carrot gold, he was supposed to get it solid instead. Like, but you know, like a ball with the Nets, like Blake, Kyrie, James, Harden, Durant. Niggas selling dope for a profit spin. On Big Bodie tucked on me in it, hardly a jam. Like, running man to the bando with it. Started with grams, then I ran it up winning. 100 grand, nigga, no candy on business. Fuck a pandemic, get bands up in it. That's your man, nigga, man, don't snitch it. Till we up hands, then this man go missing. On the
what's
dead
the
homies,
deal?
I ain't playing no
nigga.
Fuck a pandemic, get
Monday,
bands up
Wednesday,
in it.
Friday,
this
is
for the mission of the dope dealer.
9 o'clock,
pitching all that shit to the coke sniffer. Any nigga getting chip off a show with you. Reporting live, nigga, me for a loco. Plays on fire, they trying to see it in slow-mo. Make a commit a crime in HB, hella dolo. I don't give a damn how long it took. I still balled out word to LeBron hitting threes from the logo. Trade lines coming free because I own them.
LeBron
on time,
hitting
be on
threes
all the
from the logo.
Beats, I'm a photo.
LeBron
like
got a
trade
line, boy. He got a turn around. He got a step.
Never starving, nigga, working with
LeBron.
Crossover.
LeBron's
behind. Bro, got
got chickens and I'm watching out for pig shit. But like 2-3 over 2-4, man.
Kobe, you look good.
Run a man in to the band of witty. Started with grams, then I ran it up winning.
I was downtown the day before, my nigga.
Fuck a pandemic, get bands up in it.
I was downtown talking that shit the day before.
Took the up cans, then this man go missing. On the damn homies, I ain't playing no nigga. Fuck a pandemic, get bands up in it.
Fuck. It's all hypothetical, man. I don't deal with hypotheticals. Learn from D-Wade. That's a pause, right? We're pausing D-Wade, right? Or no? No, D-Wade is good.
He could have learned from him, though.
Oh, my God.
Learn something.
Of course. Okay. I'm not mad. Equal exchange. Oh, wow. He got a grown-up mentality from Dwayne Wade.
That don't mean D-Wade was better than LeBron.
I'm sure they both learned something from each other.
No, I know. I'm just saying, like he could learn from... You could learn...
For sure. LeBron calling right now, man. I know you ain't doing shit. That swollen ass ankle, man. Calling. Lakers still. Yeah, he injured. We'll be back for the finals, man. We needed this rest. We playing games. 4 games a fucking week. Fresh out the bubble, off the championship. We need time. We need time. Let us heal, AD. Andre Drummond, we got 80-80. Shout out to Andre Drummond, a brand new Laker, my nigga. Welcome home. Welcome to this championship run, man. It's time, bro. The winning is in this atmosphere. Make sure you grab your rewards and your trophies out now for a limited time. Please choose wisely. All right, let's see. Last note I have here. Let me turn the instrumental down. Last week I got a call after we went live. Shout out to Deja. She called and she was like, man, I really enjoyed God Talk. So I had to show her love live. And what she said to me was unforgettable. So of course, you know, this is God Talk. If you don't know, I truly believe God is the ultimate creator. And I always talk to my creators. I call them entrepreneurs, whatever we are, whatever you want to call yourself. I believe that's the audience I speak to. That's the audience I have. And we have a responsibility, as you know, to up the ante in all ways. So I just feel like I need to have this conversation with my nigga Chev after this call. Clearly, we popping.
Call from Tita.
Ooh. P-Dub, thank you for calling God Talk. God Talk to me.
My nigga P-Dub, what's happening?
P-Dub, my bad.
No, it's T-Dub.
T-Dub, oh, my bad. Okay.
What's up, Chef? I'm just chiming in. I'm watching. Wanted to give you some, you know, good vibes. Congratulations. I'm proud of you.
Hell yeah, man. Good looking, bro. I'm telling you, niggas don't know. Niggas don't know the real players that was there. You feel what I'm saying? You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
I was just tapping in. I want to, you know, send you them vibes. Tell you we rocking. Let's get this money.
Hell yeah. Good looking, homegirl.
All right.
Stimmy or new stimmy? Tita.
New stimmy, no stimmy.
Thank you for calling in. All right. So, of course, being a creator, being an entrepreneur, there's signs, bro. And one of the biggest signs that you know you're on the right path is shit going haywire. Mm-hmm. Okay. I say that because one, Deja is creating an LLC for her new cosmetic line. I think it's like body butters and stuff. But she created an LLC, and the LLC, on fault of the company who was filing it, it was misspelled. And of course, that's one of the biggest signs, one, because you're putting in the effort to do something, and you know what I'm saying? It wouldn't fuck up if you wasn't doing it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So you get a trophy a fuck up is a mistake is a trophy for effort. You know what I'm saying? If you look at it like that. And then I have some other things. My homegirl, Juice by Nisha, she got a hair softening conditioning mask. I watched her make the product and all that shit fell off the table. You know what I'm saying? So it's just crazy. It's crazy. Yeah, what else? That's enough. But basically, I'm just saying these signs of things going wrong are sometimes the biggest signs that you're on the right path and that you're doing the right thing. So I want to talk about Chev. In the spur of the moment, bro, when things go terrible, how do you get right? How do you get your mind back together?
Man, I ain't going to lie. I be panicking sometimes. I panic and then I be like, man, stop fucking panicking and get on your shit because. That's another cold logic to think of. It's a fucking trophy because it wouldn't fuck up if it wasn't happening.
Yeah.
Like, if you wasn't doing nothing, then nothing would happen.
Facts.
So, yeah, just like when we try to do gang with it, the video, like we were trying to do it at the homie house and just under the circumstances, like it couldn't happen there. So, we had to figure out where it was going to go. So, we end up... So it was just a fuck up. It was like, it wasn't a fuck up, but it was like, damn, we got an hour and 30. People finna start pulling up and we don't know where we finna go. So then, shout out my nigga Mike D. Like I said, bro, handle the business. And so, So, what happened? Oh, so I'm on the phone. Like I said, I'm on the phone trying to figure it out. And that nigga called back. And the homegirl Marty, like, nigga, he like, we could do it at her house. She said niggas could pull up. And we pulled up. I had the cameraman, called the cameraman. He pulled up. And shit, that shit, go tap in with that video, with that gang with it video. That shit hard as fuck. Homies pulled up. It was lit. But it was like that logic is cold because that was a trophy. Because if we wasn't doing shit, it was... Shit happens all the time. That's why shit is called spare the moment. Problems. When your shit, you trying to make something happen and you fuck up. I'm thinking about it like, damn, that's a trophy because I should look like Jordan. My shit should look like Jordan with my MVPs and my championships because my shit, a lot of shit fuck up. What we trying to do, like, a lot of shit be bad. Like, nigga, I'm got cases going on and shit, nigga. I might be going down, you feel what I'm saying? It might be time, nigga. I might have to sit down for a minute, take a vacation. And shit, nigga, we still going. We still at this. And shit still happened. I should drop the tape. And we working. We still working. Like I said, me and Smith got a banger coming. And yeah, that's a cold logic, bro. That's what I was getting to. Like, I'ma look at it like that. That shit cool. Cause
nigga, I heard every word you just said, nigga.
Yeah. Yeah. That was a cool note.
All right. Spur the moment out right now. What's the, if you recommend a track that they go listen to first, after, or excuse me, if they, let me ask this. What's your favorite track on the album? Let me do that.
Man, it varies now. So, at first it was No Stimmy. But now, right now, it's Bandemic. But that's out right now. That's the single. I would say go listen to
Facts.
But listen to 310-810 with YNJ the Coochie Man. That shit retarded. That shit retarded. You feel what I'm saying? Like, I kind of stole his drip on it just because he rap crazy.
Coochie Man.
And I'm like, shit, I'm going to rap like that. I'm going to rap crazy. Let's get retarded in this motherfucker. Like, but I'm gassing. I'm giving bars and shit. And he going stupid. He giving bars and shit. So, you know, that's how that shit go. Yeah, go listen to that. That shit hard.
Right now, spur of the moment in your motherfucking pocket. I see y'all on motherfucking Friday, 9 a.m. Shout out to all the previous guests, everybody that inspired me, man. Steve Harvey, Nick Cannon, Breakfast Club, Charlamagne, all y'all niggas, man. Big boy, I love y'all, man. All the greats, man.
Tap
we be talking
in.
Our
Tap
shit.
Tap in with my nigga God talk.
But we love y'all, man.
That's lit, bro. This shit lit.
You the only repeat guest I ever had, bro.
Yeah, bro. We gonna keep coming back. If we get big, we get this shit go, you feel what I'm saying? Then we keep coming back, then niggas gonna wanna tap in with you. But then, nigga, but then we can do exclusive shit. You feel what I'm saying? Like, man, let's talk on me here, man.
Say less.
Man,
oh, man. Hey, I'm going out on my plateau song, No Stimmy, man. If you ain't worked out today, make sure you get it in. It's Work Wednesday. Get your motherfucking work in. I hope you took away something. Hope something resonated with y'all. I'll see y'all on Friday, man.
Stop playing with these niggas. Man, stop playing with these niggas.
Walked in with some B-dogs in your apartment, boy. Nigga reppin' Eagles till I'm sleepin' a coffin door. All I get is green, but if it's beef, then I'm on it, boy. I'll instantly go from vegan to carnivore. Sweet nut-ass niggas, peace, almond joy. Sold the bro a CP, now he bleedin' the sign of stores. Hit Christian Didi, hit CC and Michael Kors. When it copped the Beamer, it was free up the FICO score. The M3, just the pink, now it's adios. Copped the 223, now he's swingin' like Vominos.
What else?
This EDD got us drinking at 1942 in Casamigos like it's PC. I'm buying a stove. Take a ZZ to AT&T, have them bop the stove. Then gave the ZZ, I ate the weed, then I'm dropping them up.